Thank you. Good job. Good singing. Thank the Lord for another day, another service here. Appreciate the service this morning, and appreciate the help that we got this morning. Thank the Lord for another privilege to be back in His house. And got much to be in prayer about tonight. Let's continue to remember Miss Susan Mullenix. She's doing a little bit better today. She is home there, and she still needs our prayers, and still off a week there from. So let's continue to remember her in prayer, and let's remember all these others that has. We've got sickness all through our church, and pray one for another. Let's remember each other in prayer. Got some that's going for tests and waiting on doctor's visits and different things. So remember each one. Anybody have a special object prayer tonight? Yes, yes. I'm going to give you a microphone. Miss Jenny is. No, I want everybody to hear you. Miss Jenny is going to share something with you, a prayer request that I want you all to hear well. And I'm going to put you on the mic. Mr. Derek's going to be having kidney surgery. He's got a donor, and she's going to share a little bit about that to you. But, I want everybody to hear you, and I want live stream to hear you as well. So I'm going to give the red mic, Gary. Share with us.
So I'm going to try not to cry. But God's been so good to us. My husband, Derek, you know, is in stage 5 final stages of kidney failure. And when this journey began, you know, we didn't realize he'd been sick. He'd been sick for 10 years. We didn't even know it. You know, his blood pressure kept going up. We didn't know why it kept going up. Doctors kept just giving him medicine. Just kept giving him medicine. And it turned out that we found out he went for another test for something else, and they sent us to the hospital. And they told us at that time that he was in kidney failure. He's had blood poisoning, spent a month in hospitals. There's so much going on that God has blessed us every single moment through that. We would not have gotten through it without our Lord and Savior. My late husband, his brother's wife, so my sister-in-law, without telling us, she went and got tested to donate a kidney to Derek. We found out whenever Chapel Hill called us and said, the one person that went and got tested is a match. And they told us the name. And I was actually in the bathroom getting ready, and Derek was on the phone with them, and they told the name, and for a second didn't register with him. And then he come in there, and he's like, "Do you know who it is?" I was like, "It's Kristen." God had laid on my heart a long time ago that she was going to be the one, and she was. And so she just finished all her testing. She lives in Pennsylvania. She had to drive to Chapel Hill to get her testing done at the end of August, and we found out Monday that she's cleared to donate. So everything that we have going on in our lives, God's got a plan for that. He's got a plan for every little thing. And even in those hard times, we're grateful, we're blessed. And this has humbled us so much to know that somebody is willing to give that of themselves. And it is such a blessing. So what I'm asking the church to do, I have a box, and I've got some little cards. If y'all can write a prayer to her. You know, she won't take anything from us. We've tried. She won't take anything from us. Her and her husband both, they live on a Christian camp, and he works a Christian camp, and she's an ABA therapist for autism, and they're just really good people. And I just want everybody, please just send her a prayer. I'm going to leave that prayer box here for a couple of weeks. Just put the prayers in there, just a word of encouragement to her, because her husband is also sacrificing this as well. That's his wife. And she's given that of herself. It's just a blessing to us. If y'all can all just please write her a prayer. And I'm going to send that box off and just let her open that box and just see how much, you know, we love her. And she's surrounded by so many good Christian people. And we are just so blessed to be at this church. And we are blessed that Kevin came to our house to mow our yard. You know, we knew that God has just blessed us. And thank you all so much for all your welcoming. And we love y'all. We don't know y'all that well, but we know you're God's children, and that's the best thing of all. And we just thank you so much. But just thank you.
You did good. You did good. That lady's name again. Kristen. Her name is Kristen. So and when you write your prayer for her, make sure you write her name and it's spelled. You put it on the box, so the spelling's on the box there. Now I want to say something. When you, I was thinking, you put yourself in her shoes. She don't want anything. They've done said that she don't want anything, but to see that people took time to write out a prayer to pray for her and pray for the situation, and praying for Derek. And I'd rather have that than a box of money. Now I would. I'd rather have a box of prayers than a box of money, and I would. Because in prayer, money's going to run out, but prayers will never run out. Amen. I'm thankful that we've, our paths has crossed, you know. Down through life, you meet people, and it's not coincidence. I don't believe in coincidence. I believe in God's timing and God's ways, and that's how we meet. And very thankful you all, and not only you all, but there's others that's come and been a part of us lately. And I just thank the Lord how He's just worked everything out. Amen. And So remember that, and that's still in the works of when all this is going to take place and when the surgery is going to be. I think we're waiting. I think more tests and lab works and stuff he's got to have. And so just pray for that transition as well. And Derek's health, he's got other issues going on. The dialysis, the fistula that they had to recently put in, as so far so good, that's working, things are going good, so pray for that as well. We're just so thankful you all have come our way, and we appreciate you. All right, so remember that. When she mentioned that to me, I was like, yes, I want you to get up, and I want you to tell people what the situation is and what's going on and how we can pray for you and how we can pray for the situation. That means a lot, you know, when you know specifically how to pray for somebody. All right. Anybody else got a prayer request? Yeah. All right. Let's remember that family. Yeah. Amen. 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 Remember that request. I didn't hear the rest of that. Alvin's mama fell. What did they say about it?
I think that she broke her shoulder.
She broke it. I was hoping that wasn't going to happen. But let's remember Miss Frankie. That's Alvin's mother. She fell this morning, and when he came to church, he said she wants to wait till later in the day to go get checked out, but they think she's broke her shoulder. So let's remember Alvin's mother, that shoulder. Yes, let's remember. That's Ward. That's Ward's brother-in-law and sister-in-law, James's and serious condition there at the VA, and he's just if it's the Lord's will, the Lord can turn things around, can't he? But it's going to take a good Lord. He's a sick man, ain't he? So let's remember James Necessary. That's Ward Hurt's brother-in-law. He's a good man. Sure is. Man, let's remember that. We all don't need peace.
Started getting sick sometime in the day today. Before I got back home from church, she's running a low blood fever, chilling real bad. Remember
that. If you remember my dad, he's got a pinched nerve in his back, and he's been dealing with that for over a week now, and close to a week, I guess. Lost count how many days it's been, but it's affected his walking and standing. He can't hardly tolerate a lot of that, so he's okay sitting, but I think he's been preaching sitting down, so it's took its toll, and he's going second round of steroids and therapy and all kinds of different stuff. So I'd like to remember him in prayer. We're just not used to seeing him down. But keep him in your prayers. And Corbin, a lot of you asked about him. We had to take him back to the Shriners this week. They think he's got a pinched nerve in his neck. That's why his arm's going numb. He's just got a lot going on, but I mention everything going on because we got so much going on. But he's taking it in stride. He's doing well and going for therapy for that. And we still hadn't got all the news back from Memphis about his stomach, but the biopsies that they took of his stomach has come back benign. So thank the Lord for that. That's good news. But as far as the results from the camera going throughout the GI tract, we've not received that back yet. So just keep him in your prayers of that. And then this winter, sometime around Christmas time, he'll be having his jaw surgery. And where they'll break his jaw, upper jawbone, open the airway. But then they'll fix his teeth as well at the same time. But I appreciate everybody's concern and everybody's prayers. Someone asked me earlier, like, don't say much. What's going on with him? So thank you for your prayers for him. He's doing good. I mean, he's got his problems every day, but he takes it in stride. He's preaching today up at St. Paul and in Beulah Dean. He preached there this morning. He's preaching again tonight. And the Lord's really using him and helping him and with his health. And I'm very, very thankful. So thank you all for your prayers for him. Yes. Yes. Remember that. That's Miss Gertha's neighbor that's got this disease, very rare disease that's took their mind. Let's remember that. Darren's aunt passed away, Jeanette Quillen. Let's remember that family. We have an earth service tomorrow, so let's keep that family in our prayers too. Junior Garland, owner of Dairy Ace, passed away. And they'll be having a private service for him. And so let's pray for his family as well. So thankful Junior got saved just a few weeks ago. And very, very thankful that he accepted the Lord. And that makes this occasion a whole lot easier. Sure does. All right. Unspoken requests, lift the hand. Let's all can and will come around the altar. Those unspoken are just as important. I want to remind you of that. Brother Jim, lead some prayer. Done on earth. Amen. Anybody got a song or a testimony in your heart tonight? Okay. All right. You pray for Miss Nancy as she comes.
You know, we all have so many needs in our lives. And I've never had one need in my life that the Lord hadn't met. Not a one. Y'all pray for me. When Stephen was accused, lonely and bewildered, no one that day would stand by his side. He looked into heaven and he saw the face of Jesus, and he rolled him over the tide. I've never had a prayer that he couldn't answer. I've never had a tear that he couldn't dry. And when the waves of life are so high, you came out them, he'll roll you over. And my life becomes a burden. I want to run, but there's no place to hide. I look up, just like old Stephen, to the right hand of the Father, and he rolls me over. I've never had a prayer that he couldn't answer. I've never shed a tear that he couldn't dry. And when the waves of life are so high, you came out there, he'll roll you over.
Turn with us. I've got several different scriptures here, but I want to start in Hebrews chapter number 11 tonight. You pray for us, Lord, just to give it to us the way he's given it to us. And Lord, just have his way tonight. What's on my mind tonight is faith's access that we have in the Lord by faith. Stand with us, reading God's Word, Hebrews chapter number 11, verse number 1. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Romans chapter number 5. Therefore, being justified by faith, We have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom we have access by faith into this grace, wherein we stand and rejoice in the hope of the glory of God. Heavenly Father, we thank you tonight for the reading of your word, and I pray, God, Lord, that you tonight, God, give us the ability, both physically and spiritually, Lord, that what we stand in need of, and we thank you for what you've done for us, and we thank you for what you've freely given to us, and we love you and we thank you. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Access is a right of way, is a something of how we can get to somewhere where we're going or get into somewhere. Now, most buildings, cars, have got a key, and in order to start that vehicle or get into that vehicle, get into a building, you've got to have the key. And that key has got to be the right key that fits that lock of that building or that vehicle in order to go in and to have access into it, right? Now I begin to think about faith is our key. We've got access now into the grace wherein we stand. And the only way that we can even get in to God is through and by the blood of Jesus Christ, right? And you think about when you've got a key, you've got ownership. You know, everybody, you've got a vehicle, and that car is yours. And that key fits your car. My key don't fit your car. Your key don't fit my car. Your key, so you've got ownership. And when you get into that vehicle, I begin to think of how that salvation has given us ownership. And we've got access to the throne of grace. And how you got in to the throne of grace was faith was the key. And that's all that the Lord requires of all of us. That's all He's ever required of any of us. Just trust me. Believe that I have died for you. Believe that I have paid the sin debt for you. And faith has unlocked the door for you and I. So that faith has opened up a lot of things in my life. You think about from the day you got saved. Boy, ain't life a whole lot different now. Think about what faith has unlocked in your life. Amen. Amen. Faith has unlocked a lot of doubt and it's casted out a wall, a barrier between you and God. But it says here from faith, it says, therefore being justified by faith, we are justified today. What does justified mean? Justified, never sinned. When the blood of Jesus Christ is applied to your soul, He washes your soul white as snow, and it's just as you've never sinned. Amen, that's what the blood does. So the blood unlocks peace, justification. Amen, He's justified by faith. We have peace with God. So faith has unlocked some peace in her life, ain't it? And it's a peace like I've never experienced before. The Bible speaks about a peace that passes all understanding. That's what faith has unlocked tonight. It's unlocked a peace. I can't understand it. I don't understand how I got it, but buddy, it's a peace that passes all of my comprehension, all of my understanding, and I know that I'm saved. Amen. And faith has unlocked that.
Faith has given me access to that peace. Faith has given you that access to that peace. Right? You know that we all, I don't know about you, but these times, and I've quit carrying them. I've got a big wad of keys, but just because there's so many doors to go through, right? There's so many things when you own, buildings or different doors, you own equipment and different things. You've got keys to everything, and it takes a key to have access to something, right? There's only a certain key that'll start some of my equipment, right? And there's keys that works different things. But I think about there's one key that'll give you access to what you need for anything in your life. And that's faith.
Amen.
That's faith. We all come up against obstacles, and I would dare say that maybe before the week's out, we're going to come up against things that we've never experienced before. Maybe doors that we've never went through. But you know what? The same key that's opened all the other doors, that's given us access to go through them. Sometimes God removes the storms, but sometimes God gives us strength and grace to go through them. But faith will be that key to get you through. Am I making sense? Man, faith is the key. Faith gives us that access. It says we've got access into this grace wherein we stand. Now, I'm thankful we've got ground to stand on. And you've heard me say many a time, when you know you're saved, that'll get you through everything in your life. Not just some things, but knowing you're saved and your assurance of your salvation will get you through the times when you have questioned every decision you've ever made. When you know you're saved, you know you belong to the Lord. You're not worried. You're not worried about surgeries that you might go through. You're not worried about situations that you know about that you're going to face. And you're not worried about the situations that you don't even know what you're going to face. Sometimes our mind takes us and we worry about things that ain't even happened yet or maybe never even happened. Am I right? Sometimes we worry and we say, what if this had happened? What if this happens? Well, I'm trusting in the Lord. And if that'll happen, if it's the Lord's will for me to face that, then He'll give me the grace to go through it. Amen. And so faith is our key tonight. Faith says, and not only so, but we glory in tribulations also. Tribulations is trouble. We all got trouble. We all go through things, don't we? Knowing that tribulation worketh patience, and patience experience, and experience hope. And hope maketh not ashamed, because the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost, which is given unto us. So, we glory. We've got the glory. We've got the victory over these troubles because of the key. Because of the access by faith. Not only do we have the glory and we have the victory over it, God gives us patience. God gives us experience. And that experience gives us hope. That experience, you say, well, what does that mean? What does that have to do with anything? That puts another chapter to your testimony that you give God the glory and honor for your life. I mean, everything you go through, every year you're experiencing things through your sicknesses and through your situations, through life in general. When you live for the Lord, amen, trouble's going to come, life's going to happen. But through it all, the living for the Lord, it just adds another chapter to your testimony through that experience, right? And that's because that faith has allowed that to happen. When you trust in the Lord, well, you've got a story to tell, don't you now? You think about it. From From the day you got saved, your story really began. You say, well, but I ain't always been saved, and I've got a life that I'm not proud of. No doubt all of us have. But our life truly began the day that He wiped our slate clean. The day that He forgave you of your sins. That's when your chapter began. That's when your story began. That you can tell that faith unlocked a door that changed your life. Amen. And through all what faith has given you the access to. Now I think about access, you know, there's codes to different things, and there's passwords anymore you got to remember to have access into things. Well, there's a password, and there's a code. Amen. When you kneel down to pray, you got to have faith. If you don't have faith, Mark chapter number 11. Now listen to this right here. Mark chapter number 11. The Bible says this, verse 24, therefore I say unto you, what things soever ye desire when you pray, believe that you receive them, and ye shall have them. See, faith is the key to that. You got to believe. So, putting it in modern terms, I guess you'd say, you got to have a password. If you got to have a password, faith is the key there. Amen? Because if you don't have faith, you don't believe what you're asking. And sometimes I believe that doubt and fear just overwhelms us and we pray, but we're really not believing. And if we're not careful, I found myself in this situation before many times, that the situation looked so hopeless that, well, Lord, I know you can do it, but I just don't know you'll do it for me. If we ain't careful, that'll cause us to doubt. And I've shared that before with Corbin, and every time we go to the doctor, we would hear, well, it's just so rare, and the reoccurrence rate of it coming back. And I mean, and when I kept hearing these statistics, and I started thinking, Lord, I know, Lord, you can heal him. I read in your word how you've touched me in my life. But Lord, I didn't know if he'd do it for us. And if we ain't careful, we can start doubting there. And what doubt will do, it'll take your peace. Amen. It'll take your peace, it'll take your comfort. But faith will get rid of all that. Standing in faith. Just stand. Just stand in faith. That's what it says there in Romans 5. Just in this grace wherein we stand. I'm standing today by the grace of God. Like that song, I know how I've made it. I've made it by grace. You know how I've got God's grace? Faith. Faith. Faith is that key. Now there's equipment. A lot of caterpillars, a lot of big machinery has a key. It'll fit a dozer. Same key will fit a dozer. A lot of you turn equipment, you know what I'm talking about. It'll fit the dozer. It'll fit the excavator, and it'll fit all of its brand, basically. Are you with me? Now, I want to say that faith is the key to everything that you need from God. Amen? He don't require another key. He just wants you to trust Him. Whatever you ask of Him, just trust Him. And I believe with all my heart, I've seen you. I've seen a lot of, been here going on 21 years. And I see y'all go through a lot. You know how you went through it? Because your faith. I give Darren Higgins a hard time. And I don't let up. Because he don't let up on me. But I'll say this. His faith in God kept his mother alive. I believe that with all my heart. There's times I'd leave her and I'd think, I don't believe she's going to make it through the night. But Darren just, but he kept praying. He said, I'm not giving up. I know God's going to take her one day, but he said, right now ain't the time. The Lord's going to bring her through this. And I'd go back to the hospital the next day and she'd be sitting up in the bed or sitting up in the chair beside the bed. How many times? I've never seen anybody except for her go be put on life support that many times and be taken off. A lot of you remember, you know, she was sick a long time. And I believe faith, prayers of God's people, prayers of this church, especially her own son, is the reason why that she made it through a lot of that. There was days that like I say, it looked bad, but the Lord brought her through. And faith can change God's mind. Amen? Faith, I believe that. I believe prayer can change things. Prayer can change God's mind and faith. When God saw the faith of Hezekiah and heard his prayer, the Lord sent word to him, you're going to die and not live. But after his prayer that he prayed, God added 15 years to his life. So faith unlocked something there, didn't it? Amen. I thought of Miss Darlene, diagnosed with cancer a few years ago. Didn't look good. Darren said, I believe God's going to take care of this. I'll never forget the phone call. I was waiting on them to come back from the test that day, just a random colonoscopy, but it changed the world. How many times have I said, one doctor's visit, one little test, one phone call can change your world? It was hard. It was hard going through that. Surgery was hard. The after the surgery was hard, but you know how they're sitting here tonight? Faith. Faith has been the key. Derek and his wife, what they're going through, faith is the key. Man, that's how we make it through all this. A lot of you sitting here without loved ones. It's been hard without husbands and wives and mamas and daddies. The hardest thing you've ever went through is losing your family. How you making it? Hey, you holding up? Faith. Am I right? It's faith. That's how we go through it. That's why we pick our head up, and that's how we keeping on, is trusting in the Lord. I'm not trusting in man. I'm not trusting in what this world has to offer. But I'm trusting in what the one has always promised me. Amen. That he owns it all. And he's in control of it all too. We forget that sometimes. He's in control of everything. Do you know he knows the thoughts and the intents of our heart, and therefore he can change the hearts and minds of people when nobody else can? I've talked to mamas and daddies before that they've been so worried about their rebellious children. They say, I don't know what in the world, how they're going to change. I said, God can change their mind. I talked to somebody this week and they thought, I don't know what's gotten into them. You can't talk to them, preacher. They get mad and they don't want to hear it. I said, God can soften their heart. Somebody told me, they said, I'm worried about my family member. They said that somebody mentioned church to them a while back, and they said, I don't want to hear it. And they cut them to the bone. And I said, but God can change their mind. God can change their heart. And it's the prayer of faith that you pray. It's your prayer. Man, I tell everybody it's important people pray for you. And it's good for people to pray for you. But remember, you've got access to by faith, your faith. What did the Lord say before He healed a certain person one time? He said, according to your faith, be it unto you. That puts a lot in perspective, don't it? According to your faith, be it unto you. So where's your faith at tonight? When Jesus calmed the storm after they thought they was going to die, and Jesus sent a hinder part of the ship, He come up there in the front end of the ship, and He turned around and He said, where is your faith? So faith can calm the storms. Faith can move mountains. Matthew 17. Let's read that just a minute. Matthew 17. There's a young boy there that had a demonic spirit about him. Disciples, his daddy brought him to his disciples, and they couldn't do nothing with him. So he came to Jesus, and he said, he brought him to Jesus, and Jesus rebuked the evil spirit out of him. They asked him, they said, well, why is it that we couldn't help the man? He said, because you're unbelief. Now, there's a lot of times we're not able to do things we need to do for ourselves or other people just because of our unbelief. You ever think of that? Sometimes we're not getting the job done because of our lack of faith. We ain't got the right key in our hand. You ain't gonna get in that door unless you got the right key. Amen. You can stand there all you want to. Just say, for instance, if I come out here and the door was locked and I tried just any random key, and I sit there and I stood there and I turned and I beat and banged and tried to get it to turn, I could do that all day, and it would not. If you don't have the right key, you ain't going to get in. Well, same way, if unbelief is a hindering your prayer and hindering your life, and you're not really sure. I mean, this boy had a demon in him, and he would jump into the fire and back out again and foaming at the mouth. And well, they'd never seen nothing like it, probably. And they thought, my goodness, this is about hopeless, right? But they wasn't thinking that the one that calmed the sea, that parted the waters, that raised the dead, the one that was in the fire with the three Hebrew boys, he's the one that could take care of this fellow that's full of demons. Right? And not only did he do it for him, he done it again with a man named Legion, was full of demons, right? So faith is the key. And this is what he told him. He said, because of your unbelief, for verily I say unto you, this is Matthew chapter number 17, verse number 20. If ye have faith as a grain of mustard seed, ye shall say to this mountain, unto this mountain, remove hence to yonder place, and it shall be removed. Nothing shall be impossible unto you. And nothing shall be impossible unto you. That's because you got the right key when you got faith. You can remove mountains with faith. What about that? If you got the right key, that's faith. What kind of mountain you facing tonight? What kind of situation looks hopeless? What kind of big door you're standing in front of? And you don't know. Maybe it's a door. Maybe it's a mountain of a financial. Maybe it's a door of doctor bills. You think, ain't no way it's going to be paid according to what I bring in, according to what comes in. There ain't no way this can be paid. Sure can't go borrow money. I know how that works. But I also know what it's like to say, Lord, would you take care of this? God, I'm trusting in you. Somehow, some way, and bills been paid. As young, now I'm old, never have I seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. You know why? Because faith. I'm trusting in the one that's promised me it'll always take care of me. And faith is the key to that. And just talk to him about it. Talk to him like you would your best friend, because he is your best friend. Amen? He is your best friend. And truly, as the song says, what a friend we have in Jesus. Faith is a key that'll unlock it all. No matter what it is in your life, it'll unlock it all. We've got access into this grace. And God's grace is truly amazing, ain't it? Boy, John Newton, he knew what he was talking about when he pinned down amazing grace. How sweet to say. One more scripture. Hebrews chapter number 4. It tells us to come boldly before the throne of grace. Coming boldly is having faith. When you're not coming boldly, you're doubting. Right? When you're coming boldly, you've got some keys in your hand. You got the right key in your hand. You got faith. Right? So faith is the key to come boldly before the throne of grace. I'm going to read it word for word. Don't want to misquote it. Hebrews 4, I think it's 12. No, 4:16. Let us therefore come boldly into the throne of grace that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. Come boldly. That's come with that key in your hand. Faith. That's the key to everything you pray. When you call on the Lord, you want to get His attention, have faith in what you're praying about. Amen? Trust Him. I know if we went through tonight and we shared everything on our hearts, there's a whole lot of mountains that we're climbing. There's a whole lot of worries that we've all got. Some of you might say, well, I'm ashamed to even tell you what I'm concerned about. If it's a concern to you, it's a concern to God. Amen. So you take it to God. You take everything to the Lord in prayer. Take everything, not just, hey, listen, if we can't even breathe on our own, much less we can't even do anything else on our own. So we need God, don't we? Faith is the key. I hope this has helped you tonight. Every head bowed and every eye closed. Lord, we love you. We thank you. And I pray that you'd help us tonight. Lord, every time that we call on you, Lord, we've got faith. We got faith about us. We're trusting in you. Help us, Lord, to trust you. Help us to have the faith, the key of faith, every time that we come to you in prayer. Lord, we love you and we thank you. In Jesus' name, amen.